With fancy words, too. She's always acting silly, and you'll often hear her say,
"Now that's something you don't see every day."
Little brother Tyler and Mr. Guinea Pig, Pinky Dinky's always thinking big. Yes, a Rooney, Positoonie, Zip, Zam, Zoom.
Phew. Don't fit. Ugh, stay. Aw, I can't do this. It's too hard. Don't give up, little brother. Just try again.
This is too hard. I'm just gonna give up.
Want to give up when the going gets tough. That gives me an idea.
Pinky, are you going to make up a story?
Yes, sir. Rooney Positoonie. So one morning in Great Big City, Tyler was looking everywhere for his other lucky sock. It wasn't on the door. It wasn't on the floor. It wasn't even in the drawer. So Tyler decided to do some deep closet diving. Here goes nothing! This isn't a sock. It was a real, honest-to-goodness pirate's treasure map.
It must show the way to a treasure. Maybe it's a huge treasure chest filled with my favorite toy, Moo Moo Miggy Monsters, and my lucky sock. Cool. I bet Pinky will help me find it. Pinky, pirate map!
Okay, we look like pirates. Now let's see if we can think like pirates. This map is hard to understand. I'm gonna need help to, what's that word that means to figure something out?
I know that word. Decipher.
That's it. But before Pinky could decipher what the map meant, she had to turn it right side up. Now it makes more sense. Where have I seen these buildings before?
Hey! Pinky, look! The map matches the building across the street. And there's Smack Dab Park.
And the great big library.
This place with the star on it must be where we'll find the treasure. And there it is! It's the Museum of Fancy Schmancy Paintings. Let's go!
Now we know where to find the treasure!
But when they got to the museum, Tyler didn't see the treasure anywhere.
This museum's so big. We'll never find the treasure.
Don't give up, Tyler. Just think of all that treasure we're gonna find. Maybe it's cheese.
You're treasure. I just don't know how.
Maybe I can decipher another clue on this map. It's a little dark in here. Huh? Whoa.
The arrow is pointing to that painting over there. Pirates on a picnic? Is that a clue? They're not just pirates on a picnic. They're pointing at something. The next clue must be on that wall.
I don't see anything.
I'll never find my other lucky sock.
You're not giving up, are you?
Meh, I'm gonna try something else. I wonder what this does.
Good job, Tyler. It's a secret room.
Yeah, come on.
I'm right behind you.
You found the next clue, little bro.
Cool, but what does it mean? It's not pointing anywhere.
I'm gonna get a bird's eye view.
It's gotta be a clue somehow.
But I don't see anything.
Well, we can't figure it out if there's nothing to
decipher.
This is hard. What are we gonna do?
I was wondering when someone would ask me that. Take three steps across this floor, put things in order, and open the door.
Thanks, Mr. Parrot.
One, two, three.
There's the door. Wow, this is one mixed up pirate.
The parrot said, put things in order.
Let's do it. Right. That's it. Perfect.
Yeah.
The door is opening.
I'm One Sock, the pirate. This here is me treasure, and I don't take kindly to landlubbers trying to steal it.
We're just following our map.
Too bad, says I. I'm not sharing. Not for all the water in the seven seas.
I guess our treasure hunt is over.
After we worked so hard to decipher all those tough clues.
Wait, don't give up. It's time to try something else, like think big.
Shiver me timbers.
Look out, Pinky's gonna think big.
Arr.
If I have a problem, don't know which way to go, I think and think and think and think. And suddenly I know.
Come on, Pink, think. Think.
And then it happened. Pinky had a big idea.
Be something you don't see every day.
Pinky Dinky Doo knew just what to do. Tyler's sock matches the pirate's sock. So, we'll trade Tyler's sock for the treasure. How would you like to be two socks the pirate?
It matches me lucky sock!
Why, with two socks, I'll be twice as lucky. It's a deal, matey. The treasure is yours. With two lucky socks, I can find twice as much treasure!
So Pinky, Tyler, and Mr. Guinea Pig finally got to open the treasure chest. It's just a bunch of socks, and none of them match.
What did you expect from a pirate named One Sock?
Wait a minute, Pinky. Socks aren't a very good treasure.
Okay, okay. Let's see. But then they looked under the socks.
Oh, hey, boy, watch out now.
And found a ton of gold, diamonds, and rubies. And that's exactly what happened. Pretty much. The end.
Cool treasure, Pinky. If they gave up, no one ever would have found it.
That's right, little brother.
Sounds like game time.
Say cheese, please.
key, please!
Let's play What's the Name of My Story?
What's the name of my story?
Here are three story names. Tyler's Soggy Shoes. Tyler's Lucky Sock. Tyler's Freckles. So, what do you think is a good name for my story? Remember, it's gotta be about what happened in my made-up story. If it is, you say yes!
And if it isn't about something that happened in your made-up story, we shout, no!
That's right. Let's play! Is the name of my made-up story Tyler Soggy Shoes?
No! The story wasn't about soggy shoes!
Right! How about Tyler's Freckles?
No!
Okay, how about Tyler's Lucky Sock?
Yes! That's a good name for your story!
That's right, little brother!
Yay!
Let's play Who's This? Yummy Swiss cheese is a character from my made-up story. One by one, cheese holes will pop off, showing us who's back there, like this.
And when we can see who it is, we shout out their name.
That's right, little brother. Let's play. Is it Tyler or One Sock the Pirate? It sure is!
Yay!
I love making up stories. I'll bet you can make up a story too. Tyler's best sleepover ever.
Kids, time for bed.
This is the best sleepover ever.
Yeah, these Moo Moo Miggy monsters are totally cool.
Huh? Oops. Sorry, Mom. We're going to bed right now.
Aww. Can't we just play a little more? Or look at books?
Aren't you tired, Jackson?
Who?
Me?
No, not really.
Jackson, have you ever slept away from home before?
No.
I'm not sure I like it.
Not sure you like sleeping away from home? That gives me an idea.
Pinky, are you gonna make up a story?
Yes, sir, Rudy Positoony.
Come on, Jackson.
Yes, sir, Rudy Positoony.
So early one morning in Great Big City, Tyler was snoring as usual, and Mr. Guinea Pig was tucked in right next to him. Then something started ringing. I hear ringing, but what could it be? Is it my kitten mittens? Nope, too meowy. Maybe one of Tyler's Moo Moo Miggy monsters.
Moo Moo!
Nah, too milly. How about a duck? Perfect, it's my duck phone. Quack? I mean, hello? Really? Thanks. Hey, guys, wake up. There's a surprise for Mr. Guinea Pig at the front door.
Surprise? For me?
They zip, zam, zoom to the front door.
What is it? It's from Harold the Hamster. He's my friend. We went to guinea pig school together. It's an invitation to a sleepover at Harold's house.
Wow, this is a fancy sleepover. It was so fancy, it even had a... Oh, what's that word? That means a list of things to do.
Wait a minute, Pinky. I know. A list of things to do is an agenda.
That's right. This sleepover had a really long agenda.
So what happens next?
Let's see. Mr. Guinea Pig started to read the list.
Number one, hamster hot rod arrives. Number two, get in hamster hot rod. Number three, drive to Harold's house. Boy, oh boy, I'm glad Harold sent this agenda. Now I'll know what to do in a sleepover.
Mr. Guinea Pig, is this your first sleepover?
Yep.
How exciting. So that night, Pinky and Tyler helped Mr. Guinea Pig pack for his very first sleepover.
Have fun, Mr. Guinea Pig!
Just like the invitation said, a cool hamster hot rod was waiting for Mr. Guinea Pig to take him to Harold's house.
Hey, 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 it's Mr. Guinea Pig. Hey, what's up, bud?
Hi, Harold. Thanks for inviting me to sleep over.
No problem, Mr. Guinea Pig. Hey, 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 we better get going. We got lots of stuff on our sleepover agenda. Come on!
So they got right to it. The wood chip jumping contest. Then they eat tons of extra cheese please pizza and watch funny movies.
It's right behind you, Bubba.
They laughed so hard, they fell right off the couch.
Okay, now let's see what's next on the agenda.
They went roller skating.
Yeah, go for it, Mr. Guinea Pig.
That was fun.
Yeah, and we're almost finished. Just two more things to do. Get ready for bed and go to sleep.
That's no fun.
Oh, you're right. Hey, I know. We'll make it fun. We'll go camping inside the house.
So Harold and Mr. Guinea Pig made a tent in the living room and got all ready for bed. There was only one thing left on the agenda. Going to sleep.
But I'm not the least bit sleepy.
You're kidding.
Nope. Hey, wanna tell spooky stories?
Nah, I don't think so. I'm really pooped. I need to go to...
Harold? Harold?
Harold was fast asleep, but Mr. Guinea Pig wasn't tired at all.
It's too dark in here and really quiet. I don't think I like sleepovers.
There was no way he was gonna fall asleep now. Mr. Guinea Pig started to really miss his home, and especially Pinky and Tyler. So he took out his cell phone and speed dialed Pinky. Huh? Hello? Oh, hey, Mr. Guinea Pig. How's your first sleepover going?
Great, except for the sleepover part.
What is it, Mr. Guinea Pig?
Going to sleep was the last thing on Harold's agenda, but I can't go to sleep. I miss you and Tyler too much. What am I gonna do, Pinky?
Looks like it's time for me to think big!
Look out! Pinky's gonna think big!
If I have a problem, don't know which way to go, I think and think and think and think. And suddenly I know.
Come on, Pink, think!
And then it happened. Pinky had a big idea.
Dinky Doo knew just what to do. I've thought of something that will make you feel like you're home with Tyler and me. Go to the window and listen. Once Mr. Guinea Pig heard the sound of Tyler snoring, he suddenly felt right at home.
Good night, Pinky and Tyler.
Mr. Guinea Pig drifted off to sleep. And that's exactly what happened. Pretty much. The end.
Cool story, Pinky Dinky Doo. And I almost forgot. I brought Kingsley, my T-Rex. He'll make me feel more at home. This is gonna be the best sleepover ever.
Sounds like game time. Say cheese, please.
Cheese, please.
Okay, let's play a game called What Came First?
What came first?
I'm going to show you something that happened in my story.
And we're gonna say what came first. Yeah!
That's right, little brother. Hope you're ready to play. Okay, what happened first? Was it I had my big idea? Or was it Mr. Guinea Pig couldn't fall asleep? So, what came first? My big idea? Or couldn't fall asleep?
Mr. Guinea Pig couldn't fall asleep. That happened before you had your big idea.
You're right. Okay, so what came next in my story? Was it Tyler snoring put Mr. Guinea Pig to sleep? Or I had my big idea? So, what came next in my story? Snoring put him to sleep? Or big idea? Mr. Guinea Pig couldn't fall asleep. Then I had my big idea, and then Tyler's snoring put Mr. Guinea Pig to sleep. And that's exactly how it happened. Let's play What Is That Sound?
What is that sound?
You're gonna hear three different sounds, and only one is from my made-up story.
And that'll be the sound of me, snoring.
That's right, little brother. Let's play! So what do you think? Is that the sound of Tyler snoring?
No! That's a helicopter!
What do you think? Is that the sound of Tyler snoring?
No! That's a cuckoo clock!
Or is that the sound of Tyler snoring?
Yeah!
That's it! That's the sound of Tyler snoring!
Yeah!
I love making up stories. I'll bet you can make up a story too.